A 35-year-old female, known case of Klippel-Feil syndrome, presents with headache, and this is a MRI brain. So in this MRI brain, we see that there is herniation of the cerebellar tonsils. As we can see here, this is the cerebellum, this is the cerebellar tonsil, and the cerebellar tonsil is below the level of the foramen magnum. It is herniating down. So tonsillar herniation is a feature of Arnold-Chiari type 1, or basically Chiari type 1. Arnold-Chiari is a term used for type 2 Chiari malformation. So here we see tonsillar herniation, which is a feature of Chiari type 1. Along with that, we see this CSF fill space in the spinal cord, which is called as a syrinx or syringomyelia. So this is also seen in Chiari type 1. This is another case of Chiari type 1, where again we see this tonsillar herniation below the foramen magnum. We see this syrinx, which is hypointense, that is black, because it is a T1 weighted MRI. And we see that this tonsillar herniation can compress the brainstem. So patients present with this compressive symptoms, that is headache, and then it can lead to hydrocephalus as well. So this Chiari type 1 malformation is associated with Klippel-Feil syndrome. That is why the clinical history, that known case of Klippel-Feil, is important. In contrast, Chiari type 2, which is called as Arnold-Chiari malformation, is associated with a meningomyelocele, as seen in this case. So Chiari type 2 is associated with meningomyelocele is a very important point to remember. And we have already seen in the previous videos the signs in the antenatal ultrasound, that is lemon sign and banana sign in meningomyelocele. And here's the link for that lemon sign video. So remember that Chiari 1 is tonsillar herniation, can be associated with syrinx, Klippel-Feil syndrome, while Chiari 2 is associated with meningomyelocele.